Good morning, everybody. Welcome back to another reaction. Today we're going to be reacting to Mozzie, big homie from the hood. Now, I believe Mozzie is the correct way to say it. We were saying Mosey in the last one, and people were very upset. And I apologize. I know that mispronouncing names is sometimes disrespectful. There's no disrespect. Up until the last song we did by him, I'd never heard him. So, I believe it's Mozzie. So, I hope I got that correct this time. Anyways, the first song that we did, I can't remember what it was called, it's been a while. But I really liked it a lot. We actually got a lot of people that were mad that we reacted to that song because we don't understand a lot of the context into what he says. Like, you can tell he has a lot to say, but we don't understand a lot of what he says because we're not from the same area, the same culture. And it was weird. Like, people were mad at us for it. But anyways, there's a lot of people that loved us, said they want us to do more of it. So we're gonna check out this one. It's a new one, and I'm excited for it. And again, before we get started, please check out the description below. We make almost zero money on YouTube. Everything's demonetized. So if you go check out our merch store and want to support us in any way, that'd be the best way. Anyways, done with all that crap. Let's check out Mozzie, big homie from the hood.
Sentimental value, never sell the thing you gave to me. Who the king of Macramento? They gon' say it's me. I ain't tryna end up in the pen, that shit gay to me. Slap sixes on the Dell, that's the 83. This game banging shit ain't as glamorous as they make it seem. Tryna take it to the box, you tryna take a plea. My luck.
First of all, I love this beat. Like, it's just the melody of it, and it's just, it's so nice, and it's so clean. I love this. Like, this instrumental is awesome. And I like what he said there. I mean, again, I come from a completely different culture. I mean, where I'm from trailer parks and meth heads. You know, that's kind of, that's the era we grew up in. But how he says, you know, that this gangbanging stuff is not the glamour that they make it out to be. And I think a lot of musicians, and they glorify it, in my opinion, just from my, they glorify it. I mean, and a lot of musicians and a lot of media, they glorify a lot of things that aren't actually as it seems. And so, yeah, I like that. And especially too, obviously, it's from what I know about him from the comments and stuff, it sounds like he's from that background. And so him saying, look, it's not, has a lot of validity to it.
Well, you said that if we lose, he'll weigh the feet. Hoop court was overcrowded, had to play the streets. Every time you needed a bond, your mom came to me. Blow Alexander McQueen's for the bunions. I'm cut from something different, really bleeding this circumference. Kale used to tell me that a bundle bring abundance. We was doing 2 for 15, kind of reluctant. Mama know I'm hustling, can't say nothing about it. I'm putting food in this refrigerator, and I ain't ate nothing out of it. Remember?
Mom knows I'm doing this stuff, but can't say anything about it because I'm putting food in the fridge. That's tough. That's tough.
Yeah, but no hope in the hood. If you ain't selling dope, then you was broke in the hood. Name ring bells, well known in the hood. Ask the cashier, rip the stones in the hood. We had it rolling in the hood. Big homie in the hood. Ranking up there, let me show you around the hood. Never out there, I live only in the hood. Know the phony and I'm good on dead homies. Tell the best, a sack of loaf and then you got a cookie. They get chilly in the trench, I need a Mozzie hoodie. Looking for consistency when I be copping cookie.
I'ma love what your hustle, baby, not your pussy. How you run me out the hood and I'm the one who run it. I'm the one that make sure ain't any of my wants for nothing. I'm the one that motivate them, baby, ask the youngest. So I'll re-up with the 20s, gotta stack the 100s.
I'm the one who motivates them, ask the youngins. This guy, like, just again, this is only the second song I've ever heard from. But based on the comments from the last one, it really sounds like this guy, he is, like, he does exactly what's going on in this video. Like, he's involved in the community. He gives back to the community. He supports the community. Like you said, he's somebody that the youngins look up to. And to me, it seems like that's a good person for any young person to look up to. Somebody who is doing that, who is saying, look, don't go to prison. It's not cool. Don't get into trouble. Don't do this gang stuff. It's not cool. Like, that's something that anybody can look up to. So, I think it's awesome.
Hey, we just thuggin' tryna rap, you a rapper thuggin'. Went to sleep inside that Bennett, building at the hustle. You switched sides at the slide, it was all for nothing. Why you copin' Hellcat if you ain't dog enough? I ain't tryna split the profit, either all or nothing. Gonna take my girly face to terrorize them all or something. We never cry about a bitch's death, he had it bummer. I seen 10, 50 times false fall on her. Yeah, remember it was no hope in the hood. If you ain't sellin' dope, you was broke in the hood. They ain't ringin' bells, well.
In that line, if you ain't selling dope, you're broke. You know, it's, again, I'm not from that culture. I come from, you know, like I said, background of a, you know, 1,000 people in a town, and half of them live in trailers and half of them do meth. You know, again, we're not from there, but I think that there are a lot of similarities in, there are obviously differences, but there are also a lot of similarities that get that don't get talked about between, say, kind of where I'm from and kind of like where Mozzie's from. Again, I'm just making an assumption based on what I know of it, which isn't much, but, you know, there's not a lot from where there's not a lot of ways to make money. Either you're a drywaller, like my dad and me, you're in some kind of physical trade, drywaller, framer, roofer, pretty much, or you're a dealer. That's pretty much it. And usually the dealers, when I was growing up, had a lot nicer stuff than the rest. So they made it look tempting. And I don't know exactly. I'm not from there, but I think that there are some similarities that don't get talked about that we actually might have in common about where we're from. Instead of, you know, we get told a lot on this channel that we sometimes can't speak on music like this because we have no idea. And you're right. I don't know specifically about where, you know, Mozzie's from and the hood and that kind of stuff. But there's some bad stuff that goes on where we're from. And I, like I said, I think there's some similarities that we have in common at times.
Known in the hood, ask the cashier, rip the stones in the hood. We had it rolling in the hood, big homie in the hood. Ranking up there, let me show you around the hood. Never out there, I live only in the hood. Know the 40 and I'm good on dead homies from the hood.
I want that barbecue, by the way.
Sorry.
right, everybody. That was, I liked that a lot. I right off the bat, I love the instrumental. Instrumental was incredible. Just was so clean, and it added a lot of depth to what he was saying. And that's what I recognized on the last one too that we did. The beat was perfect. Like, it just matched perfect and just added that depth to it. I think that that's huge. I think that some of the best rappers out there are good at that, finding a beat that complements the message they're trying to get across. Because I think I think the beat can really sometimes deter away from the message you're trying to get if it doesn't match good. And so I that was perfect in my opinion. Lyrically, I thought it was amazing. I really did. I want to go back and listen to some more. But I think he just spoke on us. It was very real, and it was very raw. And it was something that, again, I think that people from all different walks of life could listen to that song and pull something from it. I think from what I know out of two songs and comments from the last one, I think he is somebody who is very active in the community and really wants to help people, not only through his music, just in an everyday life. And so I think that's really cool. It's really admirable. And I really hope for the best for him, and I really hope that Mozzie can continue to do that and continue to impact people, because I'm become a fan of him now, and I want to listen to more of his stuff because I'm pulling stuff from it myself, and that's what it's about. So thank you guys for watching. Please put in comments below some other of Mozzie's songs that we should check out. And go check out the description below. Again, check out our merch store. Almost everything's demonetized. We make almost zero money on YouTube. And so if you want to support us in any way, that'd be the best way possible. And again, like, subscribe, comment, hit that bell button. We're really trying to race towards 10,000. And we appreciate all your support. And we will see you guys next time. Merry Christmas.